Hello everyone, my name is Sumit. Welcome to my channel Sumit Tube. In this tutorial series, we will learn how to design beautiful apps using MATLAB app design. We will start with the basics, like how to drag and drop components, edit their properties, and write callback functions. We will be designing all of our apps from scratch and explaining the process step by step, making it very easy to understand the design flow. First, we will learn about different components by creating some simple apps. Then we will design professional apps that include different components, private and public properties and functions. We will also cover some complex examples such as designing multi-window apps. After designing apps, we will learn how to make standalone desktop applications and share them with other users. They can install and run the app like any other app without needing to have MATLAB installed on their computers. I'll create a YouTube playlist including all the MATLAB app designer videos. I recommend watching the videos in order so you don't miss anything. The MATLAB version I am using is 2023B, which is the latest version at the time of making this video. If you are using a different version, you may notice some differences, but the core functionality remains the same. So it does not matter which MATLAB version you are using. Okay, so let's get started. In today's lesson, we are going to learn about two components. One is button and another one is label. On the click of this button, this label would change. For example, if we click on this, we can see the word hello world appears here. We would also learn how to show number in this label, how we can show multi-line text here, as well as some nice equations here. So let's see how we can do that. Now we are inside MATLAB. Let's open a new app designer file. To do this, click on this new button and then choose the last option, app. You would see a app designer start page would appear. As this one is the introductory video, let me give you some idea about this app designer interface. First, we have our toolbar. Here you can see different components, and this is the window where we are going to design our app, and this is our component browser. Right now, we have our app and it has this UI figure. That means this one. It always comes when you open a new file. And here you can see different properties. And here we can write some callback function. Okay, at first, drag some label here. Okay, it comes with this default text label. You can change it. For example, let me write my YouTube channel name, Sumit Tio. Okay, to see the text, you have to click outside. Okay, this is Sumit Tio. Okay, let's increase the size. When you drag this, you can see MATLAB is giving you this alignment hint. Okay, let's put it here. Now let's change the font size to 48, align in the middle, font weight, change the background color to this, maybe this blue one, and change the font color to white. Okay, so this should work as our label. Now, one thing you may notice, when you change the text, the name of this component changes. Here this one is the our label component, but you can rename it. To rename it, you have to double click on this and let's give the name to banner. After changing the name, if you change this text, it does not change anymore. Okay, now we have our label. Let's bring a button. This is the button. As usual, let's make it bigger so you can see easily. Okay, let's change the font size to 24. Okay, so if you want, you can add some custom icon like this one. Okay, now this one looks good. Okay, now let's run this program. You don't have to write any code. You can run this program at any time you want. Okay, right now we can see our button. When we click on this, nothing happens because we haven't written any code yet. Or this button, when you pushed on it, it seemed to press and release. It does not hold its state. On the other hand, this label, it would show you static text. That means you cannot change this text manually. You have to change it through writing code. Okay, now let me bring one more label here. Let's change the font size to 24. Let's make it bigger. Okay. So what we are going to do, we are going to write some callback functions. So when users clicks on this button, this text changes. Okay. Now there are three ways you can write callback function. One of the way is to click this app dot button, and then if you right click, you can see this callback function. Alternatively, you can click here and right click. You can see you can write callback function here. Okay, one more way, when you have selected this button, you can see here property and you can see there is a callback options here. Okay, now let's select this and add a callback function. Okay, when you click on this callback function, it will automatically takes you to this code view. At first we are this design view, and this is the code view where we are going to write codes. As you can see, there is already some code written here. Matlab has already written this code for you. You can see it in this gray color, and there is a portion where you can see the color is white. This is the portion where you can write code. Now we are inside this button pushed function, which is the callback function. You can see the callback function mentioned here. This is the our function. Okay, here you can see the screenshot of our app layout. When you go to use design view, you can see the whole app, and when you go to the code view, you can see the here. And this one is interactive. For example, if you click on this button, you can see this button is selected. If you click on this label, you can see your label is going to select. Okay, so time to write some functions. Now you all know about function. It's a block of code that performs a specific task. Callback function is a special type of function which is associated with a specific component like button. Every time user interacts with the component, this function will be callback. Hence, they are known as callback function. For example, if a user clicks on this button, this function will be executed. So before writing any code, let's understand some basics. First, we have our apps. Now it can have multiple components. For example, we are showing here a slider. Now this component can have different properties. For example, its current value, its background color. To access a specific property, we have to use this dot notation, app dot component dot property. For example, consider here the label. First, we have our app, then we have our label, and the property we want to access is the text property. Now, we want to write hello world as a text. So, we would write hello world, and we can see the hello world as the text here. Now, MATLAB handles text in two different ways. One is character vector, and the other one is string. For character vector, you have to use the single quote, and for string, use the double quote. You can use any one of them, both of them are fine. However, I prefer using string because it offers some additional flexibility. In our simple app, when user clicks on the button, we will see some text in the label. Now the callback function would be associated with the button because that's where the user is going to interact. The name of the callback function is button pushed. Every time this button is pushed, this function is executed. Now this function has two arguments. The first argument is app, which is the most important argument because it contains all the components and their associated property. Now inside this function, we are going to set a specific text in label. In our case, it is hello world. The reason we can call label inside this button pushed function is because of this app argument. Now let's see it in action. On the click of this button, this function will be executed and we will see the word hello world in the label. Now, as you remember, we are going to change this text of this app.label. Now we need this app.label. One way to do this, we can drag this and put it here. you can see this app.label appears. Another way we can do this, first put your cursor where you want to write this, and then select it and right click, and you can see there is option called insert app cursor. So if you click on this, you can see app.label appears. But anyway, we are going to type this by ourselves. When you are going to type app dot, you can see Matlab is showing suggestions. Then use your up and down key. For example, we need label. After selecting the correct one, press the tab key. Okay, app dot label. Okay, now we need the property text. Now there are so many properties here. What we can do, we can, as we know, this property is text, we can write T, E, and Matlab automatically filters down and show you the text. Okay. So we want to see the word hello world in our label. Okay. So this is our code. Let's run this code. Okay. So what is going to happen when we would push this button, this label would change and it would show hello world here. This one is fixed. We are not going to change this. We are going to this label because this one is this app.label. Okay, let's see if this one works. We have clicked on this button and we can see the word hello world here. So this one is working perfectly. Okay, what if we want to see some number? If you write number directly like 3, it would show you an error because it expects text, not any number. So if you click on this button, you can see it shows you an error because it is expecting a string, not a number. What we can do, we can use a built-in Matlab function, which is number to string, num to str. And it would convert this 3 number into a string. And it should show properly because now this is converted to a text. Okay, let's click on this and we can see the number 3 here. Now this is not a number, this is actually a text. Okay. Now what if we want to see multi-line text? For this, we have to create a string array. So let's use square bracket. Now remember, we have to create a string array, so you must have to use double quote. This one is very important. Use double quote, do not use single quote. In first line, we would see line 1 and the second element would be line 2. Okay, let's see. Now if you click on this button, you can see this multi-line text, line 1 and line 2. Okay, now let's one more example where we can show you some equation. To show latex equation, use this double dollar sign and then write your latex equation. Is it to be x square dx and end with this double dollar sign. Now, if you run this and click on this, you cannot see the equation, right? This is the exactly one which we have typed, but we want to see the equation in latex format. Now to do this, what you have to do, if you click on this label, there is an interpreter property. It right now it's set to none. You have to set it to latex. If you set it to latex and this, now you run this program. Now you click on this and you can see this nice equation. Okay, one more thing. Let's change back to none and click here again. Okay, now we have see the exact thing we have written. Now, like text, interpreter is also a property of the label. So we should change this is using our code. So to do this, we have to again app dot this component, which is the app dot label, and the property we are going to change is interpreter. So in here is our interpreter and we have to set it to latex. So right now we are changing property through coding, not manually. Remember, this interpreter is set to none, but we are changing it by writing our code. Now let's run this. If you click on this, you can see the equation. The interpreter is still set to none, but you can see the equation properly because we have changed the interpreter using some code. So we have seen how we can and show you some text, multi-line, some number, as well as equations. That's all from today's video. Hope you have learned something new today. Let me know your thoughts about this tutorial series. Add your comments below this video. As usual, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching, and I am going to catch you in the next video.